coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Tell you, I have absolutely got to be focused today and get to all the news, the science news, the technology news, the police state news. It is all just over the top important. We don't have any guests today, ladies and gentlemen, on this live Friday edition, so we will take a lot of your phone calls. I'll try to go to them as quickly as possible. Obviously, John Kerry has been subpoenaed finally on Benghazi Gate with these new emails. I even saw a clip this morning on CNN on YouTube from last night where they were talking about the same clip that I'd seen where the press secretary, Carney, goes, oh, that part of the memo, the email that says we need to all follow talking points, that doesn't deal with Benghazi, even though the memo deals with Benghazi. And the host of CNN, the reporter, says, that's like holding my hands up and saying these aren't my hands. Remember Gibbs, the former PR propagandist for Obama, famously last year went on MSNBC and made a joke. And he said, look, there's a drone program that's public, killing people all over the world, and we're told to tell the press it doesn't exist. That's like saying the sun didn't come up this morning. But separately, even though one CNN host is telling the truth, I've got a CNN article, and it's got an accompanying video report here, where they say, is Benghazi important or is it a right-wing conspiracy theory? And that follows the old Clinton memo to tell mainstream media in the early 90s, anybody says we're corrupt on Cattlegate, Vince Foster, which was all true. Well, all you do then is basically say they're a conspiracy theorist. So some reporters want to still have ratings and still not be a complete joke. And no, it's not going to fly saying, oh, the Benghazi memo is not about Benghazi. That's not going to fly anywhere. But other reporters are basically saying that. So it's just like when we published 2 days ago the article that had links to the Justice Department saying that, you know, banks don't have gun shops or things as customers because that's a high-risk, you know, thing. Outside of law, it's a sanction on gun dealers and the gun industry. They had their disinfo operatives running around like chickens with their heads cut off saying that it didn't exist. By the way, guys, before I forget about it, I heard 590 this morning covering it off the news, and I didn't have a chance to search engine it. They've had some group that I would imagine is connected to Bloomberg saying, we're coming out with biometric guns, and the NRA is threatening us and doesn't want us to sell them. What's wrong with biometric guns? Well, the problem is you're going to ban all our other guns and make us get biometric guns. And the attorney general admits they're debating and discussing an executive order to do that. And even Senator Cornyn has come out 2 weeks ago and said the plan they're pushing, and he warned the president not to do it, is to sign an executive order. So another example of how they play the part of the victim. Look, if you want to make a biometric gun and sell it, that's your business. The thing is, none of us are going to buy it. And we know it's a Trojan horse to go after our guns, admittedly. And so that's why people are so against biometric guns. I'm not against a personal biometric safe that isn't wired into a smart meter with my biometrics. I have biometric safes for long guns and handguns because you just put your thumb on it, boom. Well, one of them's an index finger, and boom, the drawer pops open. And as long as you've got fresh batteries in it, you can get to the gun instantly, but my children can't. So I'm not against technology. I'm against the improper deployment of it. But that's not even the big news. I want to talk about payrolls in the U.S. rise. Most since 2012, unemployment, they claim, has dropped massively. And if you believe that, you believe in Santa Claus and that he rides a magic carpet pulled by Easter bunnies. We've just got so much news coming up today. Stay with us. It's going to be a jam-packed transmission. Infowars.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
The globalists have controlled the mainstream media for a long time, but now they're expanding, making the weaponization even more vicious and deceptive. All the major networks are state-run.
We are partnering this year with the NFL.
The NFL has become a political weapon against the Second Amendment and pushes Obamacare. MSNBC tells us that our children belong to the state.
We have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents or kids belong to their families and recognize that kids belong to whole communities.
It is more important than ever to realize that we are not the alternative media. We are the true media. The establishment dinosaur press is dying.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
Join us at InfoWarsNews.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Members can share their memberships with up to 11 people. By subscribing, you will literally be buying war bonds in the InfoWar to expand our operation in the face of the tyrants. Join us at PrisonPlanet.tv.
In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Well, my friends, it's hard to believe that it's already the second day of May, 2014, on this Worldwide Friday edition. I am your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be here for the next 3 hours live. And I'll be back with an original Sunday transmission, 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time as well. Again, thank you so much for joining us today. Where to begin? Where to start? Let me just mention some of the stacks here. House GOP, Obama withholding emails is criminal. Finally, we're getting some of the proper statements that deal with reality. Finally, we're escalating up to the level of the globalist. Top general says we didn't even try to save American lives in Benghazi. That's because the plan was to kill those people there who had criticized giving missiles to Al-Qaeda, which we later learned about. Continuing, ladies and gentlemen, they have now subpoenaed the Secretary of State, John Kerry. And I have those documents that we're going to be going over dealing with that. But the response of people like Jay Carney We're going to play that clip coming up. The White House press secretary is to say it is a right-wing conspiracy theory that basically Benghazi didn't even happen. Issa subpoenas Kerry to testify on Benghazi, and Carney responds saying it's, quote, a conspiracy theory looking for a conspiracy theory. No, you got caught lying about the emails. You got caught ordering the stand down, and it's all coming out. Here's the headline. Carney on Benghazi is a conspiracy theory looking for a conspiracy theory. You would have to ask the State Department about how they responded to FOIA requests. So they've been caught in their super Nixon moment already on Fast and Furious, Shalindra, all the rest of the endless corruption. And now they're caught red-handed on this. I mean, Obamacare is a giant criminal boondoggle. But the Republican leadership comes out and says, hey, it's a done deal. It's for good. Stop complaining. 80% of you that don't like it, including most Democrats, you're going to accept it. It's, quote, here to stay. You will be assimilated. It's over. So that you just become helpless. If something is upwards of 80% or more negative, is a total ripoff, all these big corporations are exempt, it's designed to screw everybody, death panels, increasing prices, lowering care, on its face being challenged everywhere, and they say, it's here to stay, nothing you can do about it. Remember Baghdad Bob, that was his nickname, the Iraqi information minister? They ended up taking tapes of him and having best-selling DVDs sold online in 2003. I even bought one. It's somewhere here around the office where there's planes flying behind him, 2 miles behind him, explosions, the ground is shaking. The American pigs have been defeated. They have been driven out of Iraq completely. Missiles firing, explosions behind him. I mean, this is wild. This is the equivalent of walking in and your wife's got a guy on top of her in the bed, no covers. You see everything going on. It's your neighbor. He turns to you and says, hey, Bob. Hi, I was over here checking your air conditioner for your wife. And you say, no, Jim, you're on top of her. You are having sex with my wife. And he gets off and he goes, that's outrageous, standing there naked in front of you. No such thing has happened. And this is just ridiculous. And you say, okay, well, what's that? What's what? Why are your clothes off? I mean, it would be hilarious, redonkulous, I think is the word, if it wasn't so serious. Can you guys find online Baghdad Bob? I wanted to play some of him today for people that forget him. He's wearing a black beret and he's wearing like a camo outfit and he's up there going, ridiculous, our forces have crushed the Americans and the coalition, driven them back, back, back. Yeah, yeah, there he is. Yeah, yeah, turn him up. He's in English. Oh, my goodness. I tell you what. It is just so, so incredible. You know what? We'll get him on for you later, folks. The whole point is that, look, we even have the DVD. I told you, they're not a sponsor. They haven't sold these in years, but I mean, I told you, I own it. They somehow found it back in the video library. Baghdad Bob.
It's good, as you said. As you said, the traffic and everything is over. Their allegations, I think it's some kind of a cover to their failure. This is a fact. You can check it. One. Second, they are not in hold of any Iraqi town. They are on the move. As I have mentioned, they are deceiving their soldiers and their officers that aggressing against Iraq and invading Iraq will be like a picnic.
Is his last name Jay Carney?
A very stupid lie they are telling their soldiers. What they are facing is a definite death. They are trapped everywhere in the country. They are trapped in Umm Qasr. They are trapped near Basra. They are trapped near Nasiriyah. They are trapped near Najaf. They are everywhere. Because we will keep them on the move.
That's enough. Please turn off Jay Carney's father. These aren't even the good clips. Good job finding it in mere seconds, gentlemen. There are clips where he says they're nowhere in the country. We've defeated them, blown them up, while explosions are going off. You ought to give this to the guys in the back for the nightly news tonight. We ought to take clips